Let's discuss electrostatics. The name itself suggests electro means charge and static means rest. So when we study the charges at rest, it will come under the chapter electrostatics. So we can simply say it's a study of charges at rest, friends. So let's discuss frictional electricity. Okay, when we all talk about charges, the first thing which comes in our mind is regarding the frictional electricity. So whenever, you know, one object is rubbed over the other, the electricity is generated over it, okay, developed over, across it. We call it as frictional electricity. Now we have observed these things, okay, so many times in day-to-day life. Okay, if certain substances are rubbed against certain particular substances, they acquire the property of attracting. Like say, for example, you might have used the scales, plastic scales, okay, you rub it with hair. And what happens is they get the property of attracting the bits of papers and so on. So it's because of the frictional electricity which is being generated. Okay. Now, specific examples when we talk about the frictional electricity, you can see when a glass rod is rubbed with silk cloth, or when we talk about ebonite rod rubbed with fur, okay, they start attracting lighter objects. Now, why this all happens? Because of the charge acquired by the rod, right? So let's discuss it in greater details. Just give me a moment. Just a minute. We will discuss it in greater details. So when we talk about a glass rod rubbed with silk, okay, there is basically the transfer of electrons from glass to silk. And therefore, you will see the glass rod will acquire positive charge, whereas the silk, because it receives electrons, it will acquire negative charge. You can have a look at it. The glass rod is losing, you can see, electron. Okay, and silk is gaining electron, right? That's how, you know, they get positively and negatively charged. Okay. So similarly, when an ebonite rod is rubbed with fur, okay, again, there is transfer of electrons from fur to ebonite rod. And therefore, you can see here in this case, the ebonite rod, it exactly happens opposite, okay? Electrons get transferred from fur to ebonite. So wherever electrons go, they are going to give negative charge over there. So ebonite rod will acquire negative charge, and correspondingly, the fur will acquire positive charge. Okay, here, the picture shows everything. Now, whenever we talk about electric charge, basically the magnitude of electric charge will be equal to the charge on proton or electron. Now we all know the charge on proton will be 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Okay, that's what we have studied earlier also. When we talk about the matter or structure of atoms, here you can see we do talk about protons and electrons. Now whenever we talk about the total charge on a material or matter, in this case we can say that it will be, you know, integral multiple of the charge on electron. So the total charge Q on any object will be integral multiple of the charge on electron. So here in this equation, Q would be plus minus Ne, where N is the integer and E is the charge on electron. So here you can observe the charge can be increased or decreased in certain steps. And those steps are in terms of Ne, basically. So either it will be increased by Ne one time, two time, three time, or it can be decreased by Ne one, two, three times, and so on. So only in steps. We call this concept as quantization of charge. So time and again, we use the concept of quantization of charge for solving problems based on estimating the charge, the total charge on an object. So if we talk about the number of charges in one coulomb, okay, so if I say I substitute the value of Q as one coulomb, here you can see with this formula. So N will be Q divided by E. So Q is, say, one coulomb, Q charge on one electron will be 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. So when you solve it, you will observe, you know, the number of electrons in one coulomb is 6.25 into 10 raised to 18. So these many electrons will constitute a charge of one coulomb. Now, similarly, if you want the charge number of electrons in two coulomb, just put the value of Q as 2, correspondingly 3, 4, and so on. Whenever you want to estimate the number of electrons, you know, in a particular charge, total charge basically. This fundamental is called as quantization of charge.